Hi, I'm Brian with Pioneer Builders. Today I'm going to talk to you about modern day balloon framing, but also the building science behind it. Let's get into it. What is balloon framing? Well, instead of having your floor system sit on top of walls that you've pre-built, the walls actually go up to the roof line, and what we're doing is actually taking the floor system and attaching it to the studs. Why is it modern balloon framing? Because in the past, they would actually notch out their wall framing members and let in, so to speak, that ledger. So this is modern because we have beautiful structural screws that we get to use. It applies to the outside. You can see up here that we've already taken care of the fire blocking. That was one of the main problems when it came to balloon framing. What we have to think about is the way we're building will actually result in some concealed spaces. More specifically, in the little stud pockets right above our headers. So let me show you where I'm talking about. So there's going to be a ledger that comes up here, and we want to make sure that we take care of building science when it comes to that. So what are some of the things that we need to take care of? All right, we already have our structural sheathing. Then we have to have enough insulation to at least meet code. Now here's where the real world comes in. It's not always easy to find the materials that you need. And on this site, we have some leftover product that we're gonna be able to use up. Let me take you over to some of the product and I'll explain to you the building science behind it. If you think about your wall like a cake, there's different layers. Except that it's on its side, which is not what you would want to do with a cake. All right, so we just talked about the structural sheathing. Here's our next layer. So this is the Halo and Terra product. This is from a different job site, but we had some leftovers. This is graphite polystyrene, really high R value, rigid insulation, and it also acts as a vapor barrier if you put this under your slab. So this is gonna help with our vapor, but it's not gonna be our primary solution. I'm not gonna get deep into the building code if you have impermeable insulation and all of that kind of stuff. Suffice it to say, we're gonna use this first. Now come around here, and we're gonna use this Comfort Board Rockwool insulation. We actually are using this in the crawl space already, but we're gonna use this in those pockets. So we've got the Logix brand insulation, which is 1.5 inches. This is 4 inches of insulation, and the stud cavity, lo and behold, 5.5 inches. So that's gonna fill us all the way up. We're gonna be way beyond what our code actually requires. Rockwool has a higher R value. This is like R5 per inch, so it's R10. It's thermally stable. It's gonna be a really nice thermal assembly that goes in there. So what else do we need to talk about? So something else, we're not gonna have a roof on this for a while. The cool thing about this Comfort Board insulation, it's basically made of stone. So it's pretty impermeable, impervious when it comes to the weather. So I don't mind keeping this exposed. If this was typical fiberglass insulation, it would soak up all the rainwater. Yes, Pacific Northwest, you might not have known this, but it does actually rain here from time to time. So it's a nice product to put in during construction. What else do we need to take care of? We need to think about vapor. Let me show you the next product. Now take a look at this. This is the Stego crawl space vapor barrier that we used. We have leftover, quite frankly. So this is gonna go, remember we talked about the layers. So where the Rockwool will come to the face of our studs, this is gonna end up covering over that insulation. However, it's not only gonna go where the Rockwool goes. The guys are gonna figure it out for sure, but I think what they're gonna do is pre-install it on the rim that's gonna go there, that ledger. And let's say it's 12 inches. There'll be 6 inches above and 6 inches below, and it'll basically be kind of flapped over. The top one will be flapped, the bottom one might be running loose. But in any case, what that's gonna allow us to do is roll that up onto the studs, then later the drywall will be the next layer that goes over that. Why are we doing this? Basically, it's vapor control. So where we've got our sheetrock, we'll be able to use you know, primer, some latex paint, that'll help with the vapor control. This will help where we don't have any of that drywall. There's one other thing when it comes to this, it's gonna also help us to have a nice air control boundary that will connect behind that drywall on both sides. So pretty cool. I love having leftover product. Anytime I can save money, Brian's a happy guy. What is the last layer that we should probably talk about? I'll see you over somewhere else. Now, what was the last thing we needed to talk about? Oh, I know, maybe the actual framing member. So come on over here. We've got our engineered wood products. Roseburg supplied this. This is a rigid lam LVL, laminated veneer lumber. So maybe now you'll be able to visualize this just a little bit more. But this is gonna go up on the wall, and it's gonna have, remember, the stego, and then it's gonna have Rockwool, and then it's gonna have Logix, and then we'll see how it looks. I'm gonna come back maybe tomorrow. Who knows? I've got plenty of time to actually take care of it. But to close out the video, I wanna come back and show you what it looks like actually installed. And I'm hoping I can even grab a fastener to show you the structural screw. Now, full disclosure, I work with these companies. I think it's important for you to know that. I also kind of have to say it. But hopefully you're able to learn something if you want to incorporate this on your builds. Remember, with building science, you want to understand the principles. Then, when you have some different materials that are available, you know what you can do in order to have a nice, efficient build and use up some of your products. And it's going to be some pretty high-performing parts of the wall assembly. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow when I'm back here on site.